All right, so this video is gonna be a lot more detailed. It's just gonna be on my wheel teardown and Cerakote and rebuild, and then also the brakes, same thing, teardown, Cerakote, rebuild. So I'm gonna start with taking the tires off and then go ahead and tear down the wheels. The sprocket and brake rotors are removed on the front and rear. So next thing I'm gonna do is pull the spokes out. If your spokes are bad, you can just cut them out. These spokes are still good and usable, so I'm gonna go ahead and save them so I don't wanna ruin them. I'm gonna go around and I'll just loosen the nipples just a little bit. And then once they're all loose, I'll go ahead and use an Allen and go ahead and zip them all out. And then I'll have just the wheels and the hub separated. So the rear wheel, I got all the nipples out and the spokes here. So now I'm just going through and I'm pulling them out and then I'm separating them label. So basically in inner and outer, brake side, hub side. I'm not gonna reuse these spokes, but if I ever need a spare or if I get the new ones, you know, sometimes I use the old ones to match them up to make sure I'm putting them in the right spot. Front wheel isn't going as planned. A lot of the spokes are actually already seized in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and start cutting on that and try to save a couple of them that I can, but most of them I'll probably end up just cutting out. Alright, all the spokes out, just the hubs now. I'm gonna try to save these seals and bearings. We'll just see how they come out. They don't have very much time on them, so if I can get them out without ruining them, which bearings should be easy, see how the seals come out and see how that collar comes out. I've had trouble with those before getting seized in there. Not my favorite design from Honda on those. Break down your calipers. First, you're gonna need a cool Coors Light, and then pretty much an 8 and a 12 end wrench. And I'm gonna use compressed air to pop the pistons out. So first, I'll get the bleeder out of the way. Maybe not with the brake fluid on my hands. On rubber gloves already. So this is a front caliper. I actually have this piece from Moto Stuff here that's gonna go on and replace this one.
It's for the bigger rotor in the front. Let's see if I can do this. Get that loose, and then we'll loosen this. It'd be a lot easier if you loosen this stuff before you take them off the bike. Pin out there, probably clean that up some before I put it back in. Get the pads out. And finish loosening this and get this out of the way. Just gonna slide out there. That piece, we will reuse this, and I have a rebuild kit, so I'll have new parts for there. But other than that, most of that piece will be discarded. Pull this out here. And so next, I'm just gonna pop the pistons out with some compressed air, carefully. I usually have these laying around. It works really good to stop the pistons from going all the way out and hitting the other side. I might have to find something a touch thinner. Let's see real quick here. Probably shouldn't take the bleeder out yet. Let's see what else I can find. Out there. No. And that one out. Now let's use a small screwdriver and pop the seals out, which I do have new ones, so just try to be careful not to burr the caliper. Getting these out. All right, last we'll just pull this rubber out. Now that I have brake fluid all over my hands, so I won't be able to do anything. All right, and these you can unthread. Allen on the end here. Sometimes I don't want to come out of there very easy. Let's see if I can get it out. Got too much trouble. Go. And the last thing is just to pull this pin out here. I did heat it up a little bit. some Loctite on it, so help a little. There's nothing left in the caliper to worry about ruining. So got that out, and now it's torn down, ready to clean up and get Cerakoted. So, all right, we'll turn down the rear caliper. Basically same thing, just looks different more or less. Do a bolt out of there. Pull the brake pads out. Since these are the ones that were in there in their stock, you can see that they're already kind of a little bit corroded. So what I like to do is basically put a 8mm on there on like an impact, and then get some SOS pad and basically run up and down there. It'll clean it off really good, and then just put some grease on it when you put it back in. Pop that out of there. Out of there, go ahead and pop this piston out of here. I don't know if that's actually gonna be long enough, so I'm trying to be careful so it doesn't come out too much. You want to be careful when you pop them out of there. If they shoot out of there and they ding up on the side, it'll never seal up. So see if I can wiggle it out here. There it goes. Alright, got that out of there. Same thing as the front one. Just carefully pop these seals out of here. Pull the bleeder off. Grommet. And easy as that. Another one ready for Cerakote.